will be monitored and recorded. To accept this call, say or dial 5 now.
Yeah, Max Video, Video, you know, this is for sure, for sure. Yeah, Max Video, Video, open your soul, represent your ghetto, baby.
Thank you for using Cocktail Link.
Hello?
Let's get into it. We ain't got that much time.
Alright.
So what's the deal, man? What's the purpose of this call? Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
I hear you. I hear you good.
I can hear you now.
Alright, jump into the purpose of this call.
Alright, well, I'm going to remind the viewers a little bit about myself. I'm 34 years old. I've been incarcerated since I was 17 years old for a first-degree gang-related murder. I was sentenced to 50 years to life in prison. After years of self-reflecting and participating in self-help programs, I have come to realize that my entire dedication to the gang and its culture was the title of my book. I was striving to be a failure. And now looking at life from this perspective, while seeing and hearing about how our young people continue to murder each other, inspired me. It inspired me to use my voice and my story to let our youth know that this ain't it. This lifestyle that we has been passed down to us generation after generation is not it. And I'm on a mission to break this generational cycle of self-destruction. I understand it is people like myself who know the downfalls of this culture's duty to use our stories and our experience to deter our youth from following in our footsteps. I am also the author of a gang prevention book titled Striving to Be a Failure, The Reality of Gangs, Jail Cells, and Coffins, a book I wrote for our youth, and a book I will continue to use to reach our youth.
How's your book doing?
My book is not doing as well as it was, as I am a self-published author, and I don't have full-time promoters, nor do I have money to run continued advertisements, so it's not doing as well as it was. So I ask all our viewers and all the people out there to help me promote my book and help me get it into the hands of our young people. I'm also seeking donations to help me further my mission and get books into more young people's hands, as most of the proceeds from my book are used to buy more books that are donated to youth organizations around the country. I have donated hundreds of books to all type of organizations, from L.A. to Chicago to New York to New York, as I'm trying to reach our youth in every corner of the country. So I ask everybody to please support my mission by picking up my book. It's available on Amazon. And you can also donate to my cause by sending a donation to the Cash App in the description, as our mission is saving our youth. And we need all the support we can.
How has KevMac Videos helped your book get out there?
KevMac Videos has helped my book tremendously. It has helped me get my voice out there. It has helped me meet new people, open up different avenues. And I am appreciative of KevMac Video platform. And you know, I'm excited to be back on here once again.
And how can people contact you?
Oh, well, people can contact me on my book, Instagram. You can hit up my people at, I believe it's Youth Save. And my address is also in the description. And I also would like to let people know about my new show. I have a new show called This Ain't It. It is a show where I address the destructive culture. And me and Dusty, we're going to talk about why our youth join gangs, how destructive the culture is, and what we can do to lead them into a more productive lifestyle. My show will be airing on Dusty Visions on October 3rd at 7 p.m. Please tune in. Please have our youth sitting by your side.
This call and your telephone number will be monitored and recorded.
As we are trying to break this cycle and let our youth know the title of my show, that this lifestyle ain't it. I'm sitting in prison right now. Shout out to Dusty. He just aired a teaser episode this morning at 8 o'clock. So please check that out over at Dusty Visions TV. Please hit that subscribe button and let's spread this message as I'm trying to help our youth. As I said, my show will be airing. It's called This Ain't It on Dusty Vision on October 3rd at 7 p.m. And I appreciate all the support that everybody's giving me. And let's do this, man. We got to stop this cycle, man. It is truly heartbreaking to see our young people continue to follow in my old footsteps and go out there and murder each other and come to prison. And then we sit in these prisons and it finally come to us that this ain't it. This is not what it is. And as I said already, you know, I know it's on people like me to get that point out there and drive that message home. And hopefully, you know, we stop this cycle and, you know, teach our youth how to build up the community. Rest in peace, neighborhood Nipsey.
When the recording came on, you were saying something about have their kids sit next to them while they watch the video.
Yeah, please. When you tune into my show, This Ain't It, I would love to have the youth, any at-risk youth or any kids sit next to them, let them listen to me because I plan on, you know, giving it to them raw on my show, letting them know how everything that I've been through from the betrayal in the streets to the betrayal in prison to being in prison, having to listen to another man tell you what to do, and it's not a request. It's you're going to do what he tells you to do or else. And again, this is some of the things that they don't tell us when we sign up for this gang banging or this gang culture, criminal culture, whatever you want to call it. And I would love for our youth to hear me so I can give them the full truth. I plan on doing no filtering on my show. And I'm going to let them know, you know, that this ain't it.
Did you have a message for Big U or something you want to get out there so Big U can...
Yeah, I would love to work with Big U, man. Shout out to Developing Options. I've been aware of the program of his organization for a little while. I got to donate to the organization and see how any way my voice and what I'm doing in my book can help him, you know, reach his mission, which is the same as mine, which is to stop our young people from continuing to go to jail cells and coffins.
Right. So how you been maintaining in there, man? You got your head up?
Yeah, man, my head is up, man. I'm inspired by what I'm doing, man. This is what keeps me going now, man. Reaching out, trying to, you know, do something productive, making amends, you know, for my whole childhood. I destroyed the community. I was out there, you know, doing all the things I shouldn't have been doing. And now that I got this opportunity to use all the negative stuff that I learned from that culture to reach back out to our community and do something productive. All that was keeping me going. It's keeping me, you know, happy. It's keeping me mind strong because I understand my life mission now. And this is my life mission. I have been in here since I was a kid. I have been to Pelican Bay State Prison when I was practically a kid. I stayed up there for almost 10 years and I'm still, you know, trying to get out of prison. I'm waiting on, you know, the governor to see what's going on my commutation. Hopefully some laws passed that'll help me out. But until then, I'm going to continue to do the work I'm doing. And, you know, whatever you put in life is what you're going to get out of. I know as long as I'm putting positivity into the world, it's going to come back to me. And, you know, what I'm doing, it's my heart. It's something that I love doing. So, You know, when my time is ready, you know, I'll be back out there in society.
How does it feel to be able to wake up and know you have a purpose in life now?
Oh, man, it feels good, man. It took a lot of stress off of me, you know, because for a long time I just sat in here and, you know, I didn't understand why I was in here. And every day I woke up like, man, God, why you still got me in here? But now that I have my purpose, I understand that me being in here and getting my voice out there while I'm in here, you know, it's gonna resonate more, and it's gonna be more raw, and let our youth know, like, man, this is real. This ain't a person who's on the streets and society saying this. I'm in here right now. What a life sentence is right now, as I'm talking on this phone, something can really happen to me. I can really die later on the day or a couple minutes from now. Like, this is really reality. And, you know, now that I understand my purpose in life, I understand that I am still in here because I have to do this first. I have to let them hear my voice from in here, and hopefully I inspire. And soon I'll be back out. I'll be out there doing this in the world. So to answer your question, it feels absolutely great to know my life purpose.
Yeah, well, that's a good thing, man. Last time we spoke, you almost had an incident while you was on the phone. How's things been going
in there? That was crazy, man. Well, for me, things have been going crazy, but, you know, I mean, things been going good, but, you know, prison is always crazy. Like, I seen somebody almost get killed yesterday in front of my door. They sprayed my door up and all type of pepper spray came in my cell and choked me and my celly out for about a couple hours. So, yeah, but me personally, I'm good, but, you know, I'm still in this environment, and hopefully I get free from this soon, man.
Are you still on level 4?
I'm not on level 4 no more. I'm on level 3. Thank God I ain't on level 4 no more.
Tell me the difference between level 4 and level 3 from your experience.
Well, the level 4 is, you know, that's like Pelican Bay. That's Pelican Bay is a level 4 prison. And level 4 is, you know, it's very strict. And when I say very strict, I mean when 9 o'clock comes on a level 4, and you better not say nothing. If your next door neighbor can hear you talking, you're too loud. There's no talking on the tier. There's all type of crazy rules. Like the incident that happened last time I was on your show on the phone would never happen on a level 4 because no one's going to be screaming while somebody else is on the phone on a level 4. Level 3, it's a lot more lax. There's a lot less rules and structure, and, you know, there's more programs. That's nothing on level 4. There's no program. And for all our young people, y'all need to know, when y'all come to prison, y'all don't come to the level 3. Y'all go straight to level 4. Y'all go right to where the big boys at, right where to all the dangers and the high-level real prison is at. And you're going to, if you're a young person and you're fresh in prison, more than likely, somebody going to put a knife in your hand and tell you to go handle some business that don't got nothing to do with you. Something that probably was happening way before you got to the prison, but because you a young person and you fresh in prison, you got to earn your stay on the yard.
We have 60 seconds remaining.
All right, in closing, you got a message? Anything else you want to say?
Oh, yeah, man, please, man, pick up that book, man. I need everybody to go out there and pick up that book, man. It's available on Amazon, as I said, man. All the proceeds are going back into the mission, man. We're trying to keep it in the community, man, help our people, man, and buy back the block.
Buy back the block.
This call and your telephone number will be monitored and recorded.
All right, man. You have a good one, Kev.
All right, you too. Take it easy, man. Good luck in your endeavors.
How about
that? All right, peace. I'm
reminisce about the days of way back. Big kid, dollar folders, gun holders with the gym on our rollers. Keep taking the fire with the stove. Don't make dollars, it don't make sense.